for joining me for the Kiwi Lane blog hop for August. I'm so excited to share my project with you today. I am going to be creating a really adorable little tiny mini book for those of you who love mini books. I love to make mini books because I can pretty much scrap an entire theme into one little book. And so this one is going to be an extremely petite tiny mini, and so I hope you enjoy it. I'll be inserting some photos along the way and sharing with you how I embellish a few of the pages. And so I hope you stop by the Kiwi Lane website and check out all these fun templates that I'm going to be using in my project today. So I am going to be using Journey 3. And you can see here that it looks like a little suitcase and it has little wheels down there on the bottom. And when I saw this, I thought, oh, this would be a really adorable base for my mini book. So that's the base of my mini book. I'm also going to be throwing in this shapes template. It's shapes 3T, and it's just a basic circle here. And I'm also going to be using from the journey set as well is journey 2. And this is kind of like a label template. And then I will be using some brackets. For instance, here's a tiny bracket, and this is brackets 1T, and I'll be using this as well. And I'm not sure, I might be adding a few more in as I go and as I share, but I'm going to explain my base really quick to you, and then I'll share a few photos, and then we will continue to create this together and see what it looks like at the end. Thanks guys so much for stopping by, and I really hope that you enjoy your blog hop. And the next hop on the list of places to go is to the talented Christy Lee's blog, so be sure to continue hopping after my video. I took Journey 3 and I traced it on some scrap papers that I had laying around. I knew that I wanted my album to only have 5 pages in it because this is a really small template. It fits in the palm of my hand, so you can see that I'm not going to get a lot of embellishments put into this mini. And then my pictures are going to be quite small as well. So I wanted to use some scraps I had laying around, like I said, but I noticed that my scraps were not double-sided and they weren't extremely heavy cardstock. This one happens to be double-sided, but for the majority of the scraps I used, they were not double-sided. I still went ahead and backed this with another piece of coordinating paper just to give it a little bit more stability for flipping the pages of my mini book. So basically, I'm going to insert a picture here. You're going to trace around Journey 3, and you're not going to trace the little wheels here. You're going to line this up on your paper with the wheels sticking off the paper, like this. See the little wheels sticking off there? And I'm just going to trace around all of my pattern papers, and then I'm going to glue the two patterns together that I want, and that will create my pages for the mini album, as well as my front cover and my back cover. So I'm going to insert a photo right here for you. Okay guys, so now I have all 5 of my little mini pages cut out, and you can see that it's just my pattern paper that I've adhered both sides together to make it pretty stiff. And I have another one here that I'm not showing you quite yet, but there is one more that I cut out, and they are double-sided with really adorable papers. And these were just, like I said, scraps laying around my room. So maybe you can guess kind of what this shape is going to be already. Any guesses? It's going to be a camera mini book. I'm so excited. I love cameras. So I next am going to take Journey Template 2. And I want this to be on the front of my camera, along with the round template that I shared with you. This is going to be also on the front, and I'm going to be placing both of these templates on the front as accent pieces, and they're good for layering. As you can see here, the Shapes 3T fits perfectly inside the Journey 2. So I'm going to go ahead and insert a photo here and show you just what these look like cut out. Now that I have these cut out, I took my template Journey 2 and I placed it With it cut out, I placed my pattern paper, let's pretend this is my pattern paper, right over top of my camera here. And you can see that I have some template hanging off the edges. Go ahead and I just put a tiny bit of removable adhesive on the back of this, and then I trimmed those off, removed it, and then I inked my actual paper. And then when I was done, I used some foam dots and I popped it up onto the front, which is the cover of my mini. So it will look like this. And to go along with that, I cut out the circle here, which is the 3T, in an adorable paper, which I've been hoarding, which is this right here. And I added some of the LSN craft trim from Webster's Pages around the edges. And I cut two of these circles out and etched them. And I sandwiched my trim in between both of the circles. And so that is what, so far, the cover of my little camera mini is going to look like. So guys, I hope that you continue on this journey with me, and I'll keep adding pictures in and showing you how that I'm going to start decorating my little camera mini for you. I hope that you give this a try, and I hope that you stop by Kiwi Lane Designs and pick yourself up the set of the journey templates as well. Hey guys, so I'm going to be using a bracket 1T. And all I did to this was I traced it onto some coordinating scraps left over from when I made the camera base of the mini. And I wanted it to become a folder. So I took my paper and I laid it out onto my paper like this. I traced around this one side here, and then I made a little mark here so I knew that was the center point. And then I went ahead and I just flipped my template and traced that as well. Cut it out. And this is the shape that you're left with. And then I scored it down the center where you can see I still have my pencil line right there, just so I could fold it in half and know that that was the center. As I've been playing around with this little bracket that I just showed you how to cut out a double bracket and fold it in half, and it makes sort of like a little envelope here or file folder, I've decided that when I laid it on here that I wanted to adhere this. I'm going to put adhesive on here and stick this down onto my little camera. But then I thought, you know, I kind of want this to be like a little pocket, not an actual file that opens, which there's nothing wrong with that. So if that's what you decide to do, that's perfect as well. So I thought, you know, I'm going to do one more fold in this. And just to create a little bit more pattern, to make it a little bit more user-friendly as well. So I'm just going to bring my paper cutter over to my mat here. And I am wanting to score from this curve across to this curve. And it's going to allow me to fold just this one side down, and it will reveal the other pattern paper inside, which is great about double-sided cardstock. So I'm just going to line this up on my cutting board here, and I am just going to find something to score that with, and I am going to go ahead and score that. So I don't have my bone folder by me, but I do have a butter knife, so I will be using that. So I'm just going to find the edge there, and I'm just going to gently score that. And I always have a butter knife around for lots of things I use it for. So you can see I have two score marks. And I can now press this down into place. And so now you see I have a fun little folder here. So I'm just going to put a little bit of adhesive here, a little bit of adhesive on this side, and it's going to create this cute little pocket here where I can slide a tag or a little journaling block inside there. And then I will stick that inside of my little camera mini, and that way it will become an interactive album. Let me show you here. And you can see what that looks like. And then if you had, let's pretend this is a little tag, and you could stick your little tag inside there, or your little photo sticking up, and then you could take that out, look at it, and stick it back in. So I took my 3T bracket and I've traced it out onto my pattern paper, left it a little bit on the longer side so I could have some adhesive there to attach it to my book. So you can just see it's just a tiny bit longer than the template itself. So I'm going to figure out how wide I want this, and then I'm just going to score it just a tiny bit. I just want to be able to get some adhesive on my template so that I can fold it. So I'm going to bring over my cutting board again, and I'm going to try to line it up to the best of my ability here, and I am just going to go for it. And once again, you're going to laugh at me, and I'm going to bring over my silly little butter knife and score it again here. And there's no measurements for you guys. I really do wing it. And you'll see here that I do have the score mark right there for you. So I am going to fold that, and you can see right there. And then that is where I'm going to be putting my adhesive. So I'm going to give that a pretty good crease with my butter knife here. I'm going to crease that really, really well. And I'm going to be adhering just this little part that I just folded onto my book. That's it. I'm going to leave this open. So I'm going to go ahead and adhere that down to my next page in my mini book. Hey guys, so I'm back to share with you the final project. And it is a little camera mini book that I created using the Kiwi Lane templates. And I'm so excited to share this with you. And as you saw in the video that I created this cute little camera with the Journey 3 template. I started off using Journey 3, and you can see it has like little wheels on the bottom there, which I just went straight across so there would be no wheels, so it turned the little suitcase more into a camera. And then as I built my camera, I took the Journey 2 and I laid this across here. And the excess template that was hanging over for the paper, I just trimmed that off and adhered that to the front of my little book. And then for the shutter, I used Shapes 3T, and that was just placed over top of, and it fits perfectly with Journey 2 right there. So that is the base of the mini book, and I did cut these out several times. I used single-sided pattern paper, which was not very thick, and so I cut this out several times and adhered two patterns back to back to create more of a thicker cardstock base to create the pages of my mini, and I'll share that with you. So here is my mini. It's so cute and so adorable. I absolutely love it. I used, like I said, Echo Park and some scrap sling around my desk. I just bound it with a little bit of colored twine and some of this fun tinsel twine from Webster's Pages. And then on the front here, you can see here's the little shutter, and I have the little button here, like you would click your camera. Here is the little flash, which is the paper clip, and a little sparkly dewdrop that I have here. And then I added some Webster's trim around here with some stickles and the word smile, which is a metallic word that I have here. And I wanted this to open up so that I could stick a picture there of like maybe my family. And you can see that it's double-sided there on the back, and it just closes like that. And then you can see here is the Journey, let me grab that here, Journey 2 template right here that I just cut off to create this area on the camera. And then you open it up. I kept it super simple, guys. Here I just put a little twine bow, some camera paper. And then over here, I used another Kiwi Lane template, which is the Bracket 3T, which is this one. And I just traced it out on my paper. I adhered it. I left it a little bit longer than this, actually, so I could fold that over and create a lip, and I'll show you that. And it just tucks up underneath the button. So you can see I traced it a little bit longer so I'd have a lip for folding, because I knew I was going to create like a little pocket here. So you can stick some tags inside there, some photos, do some journaling on that side, and just tucks underneath a little button here. And then on this side, all I did was a little burlap canvas heart I added on this page. And then over here, I created another pocket with the same template, which is Brackets 3T, but this time I adhered it and just made a pocket instead of a little flip out. And had a little tag in there. And then over here, I created the cute little pocket that I also shared earlier how to make, and I just traced this two times, so like that, and then I folded it And I folded this area down to create this little area here. And then I added in the little tags. So it had a little pocket here. I put the word imagine. Over here, I just added an Amy Tan sticker with the camera because it's very suiting for the camera mini. And just a teeny tiny little bit of sparkle, some sequins. And then over here, this actually is a pocket. And I just used some trim I had so I could stick, you know, a picture in here or some journaling tags. And on my last page, I created another one of these little pockets here and added in a couple little tags here to finish off my little mini book. And I'm going to share a few pictures at the end for you. And thanks so much for joining me for the Kiwi Lane August blog hop. Be sure to check out the blog hop list down below. And your next stop is Miss Christy Lee. Thanks guys so much for stopping by. And don't forget to leave a comment down below as well as become a subscriber on my blog. Thanks guys so much and we'll see you later. Bye.